Hey guys, this is Chase from Alta Labs. I'm going to walk you through the web version of our secure and scalable cloud-based platform, a resource you can use to manage your network from literally anywhere in the world. To access the platform, open a web browser and navigate to manage.alta.inc. You will need to either create an account or sign in using Google. Once you have confirmed your account and have logged in, you will notice the system creates a default site called Home Base. You can either keep the name for your first Alta Labs deployment, or you can go up to the site dropdown and rename it. You are now ready to start setting up your network. Within a few moments of connecting your first access point, you should see it appear as an available device for setup. Go ahead and click Setup. Within a few seconds, the access point will become available for configuration. You can rename the access point by clicking into the text field. To manually start a firmware update, click the arrow next to the version number. If you want to remove the access point from the current site, click the trash can. For additional configuration options, click the device icon. A window will appear with Wi-Fi, hardware, and network-specific settings, as well as the scan option for each of the Alta Labs access points. With the Wi-Fi settings tab, you will notice an option to associate colors or groups with each access point. This is our new patented method to quickly and visually associate the desired SSIDs you want each access point to broadcast. For example, if you have a security system or camera system that should only be available on a certain AP, you can associate those colors or groups here. You assign colors to an access point by clicking into the field and selecting the appropriate colors. On the Settings tab, there are a few features I want to draw your attention to. First, the Fallback upon failure option. This option is enabled by default on every access point. It allows an access point that is completely misconfigured to roll back to its last known functional state. Second, the Always On feature. This allows you to decide which access point continues broadcasting their assigned SSID in the event of an internet outage. Third, the LED status. This allows you to override the site-wide LED settings for an individual access point. Fourth, the Move To feature. This is useful for bringing up multiple access points on a single site, configuring them, and updating their firmware. Once ready, you can easily move the selected access points to any other site that you manage. On the Scan tab, you can conduct a quick scan, which takes about 5 seconds, or a full scan, which takes about 15 seconds. Don't worry about taking your network or access points down when you conduct a scan. Alta Labs access points can remain online while conducting their wireless scans. Once the scan is complete, you'll be presented with the report of the interference that particular access point is seeing. You can then use this information to adjust your channels accordingly. Now that you've finished configuring your access points, let's take a look at the Columns drop-down menu. If you want to add or remove fields from your view, simply select or deselect the appropriate item. Time-based filters appear next to the Column drop-down. Once selected, these show the average metrics for each access point over the selected period. Next, let's go to the top of our menu and select Settings. These settings are specific to the site currently selected. Here you will see Wi-Fi, System User, and Filter tabs. Let's start with Wi-Fi. This is where you will configure SSIDs for the current site you have selected. Let's go ahead and set up an SSID so I can show you more features that elevate your network experience. Start by clicking Add New. Enter your desired network name. Now, under Passwords, click Show More. Here you will see a list of predefined network types we have created using industry best practices. You can quickly select and deploy these network types by using our multi-password technology. If you plan on connecting more than 100 wireless devices to this network, make sure that you select Large, Guest, or Internet Only here. Add as many passwords as your project requires, and then select the appropriate network type to associate with each password. As your end user enters the password on their device, they will join the appropriate network type assigned to that password. Additionally, VLAN, rate limiting, scheduling, and hotspot configurations will be implemented as you configured. Once your passwords and corresponding settings have been set, scroll down and see where you can add the SSID to multiple sites. Right below that, you can assign it a color or group. By selecting Advanced Settings, you will be presented with a number of additional features. There are two I would like to highlight. First, the Schedule feature. Alta Labs elevates the wireless scheduling user experience by continuing to broadcast the SSID even during downtime, rather than shutting off the wireless network as most other access point vendors do. This allows users to request additional internet access time if this option is enabled. Second, hotspot service. Alta Labs access points all have the ability to provide their own hotspot, or they can redirect out to an external hotspot. Now, let's go select the system tab above. This is where you can set the LED status for the entire site, adjust the time zone, or enter your SSH keys. Under the Users tab, this is where you would invite additional users to manage or view the sites you have selected. The Filter tab allows you to use the powerful Deep Packet Inspection engine built in each access point. Here you can select specific applications, application genres, or specific URLs you would like to restrict at the site level. Let's visit the Devices tab at the very top of the page. You will immediately be presented with a list of every single device connected to your Alta Labs access points. Here you can rename devices, decide what data points you want presented, you can sort by every data point, you can also use time-based filters up at the top to see things like average signal strength over 1 hour or 2 days. You can also set device-specific settings by clicking the icon next to the name. You will notice you can adjust your network type the device needs to reside in, adjust its VLAN, rate limit, and decide if the device needs to be governed by the hotspot or schedule logic for the network it's on. By clicking on the user profile in the upper right-hand corner, you can adjust account level settings, like setting an avatar, enabling multi-factor authentication, and resetting your password. Finally, the dashboard. Once your network is completely configured and online, you are ready to look at the dashboard for vital information that pertains to the current site that you are logged into. You can see things like total bandwidth consumed, highest bandwidth consuming devices and applications, as well as if there are any devices in alarm. The Alta Labs management platform will continue to see new and exciting features and functionality as we continue to elevate the world of networking. If you would like to see features that are not currently available, please come share your ideas at forum.alta.inc. Thank you for watching.